My name is Mattia Meneghello. I am 22 years old. I am from Italia. I live in Corona now. I've been here for 4 years. And we're out here at Lake Elsinore for the first round of the West Coast Open. I was born here, but I was only here for 7 days. My mom came here 8 months pregnant, gave birth at good old Corona Regional, and then 7 days later went back to Italy. So I am the definition of an anchor baby, just for the citizenship. Lived in Italy for 11 years, and then my dad moved to Dubai when I was about 6 years old. And I did all my elementary school in Italy. And then 11 years old, I told my mom, I was like, Mom, sorry, I want to go live with dad. So I went to Dubai and spent seven and a half years there. Lived with my dad, had a great time. My dad actually grew up racing motocross in Italy. And he put me on a Peewee when I was, Peewee 50, when I was 2 years old. And then my mom said enough when I was three because I broke my wrist. And then I moved to Dubai at 11 and my dad put me on a 450. And then I've just been riding around since and moved here, and you know, this is heaven for motocross. So here I am. So in Dubai I did, because that's where I learned how to ride. My dad first, he made me do a lot of desert riding. You know, the desert there is not like you think here, like Ocotillo, just flat and dry. It's like full on like dune riding, and it was sick. So my dad made me do that until I was like 13 for like 2.5 years. That's how I learned how to ride. Just sent me out in the desert. And then I did my first motocross race, finally convinced them. Second moto, broke my femur. I got airlifted, got a good helicopter ride out of that, which was cool. And then I didn't race again until I was like 15, 16, because my dad was more traumatized than me from letting me race and hearing it from my mom back in Italy. And I did maybe like 5 or 6 races in Dubai. And you know, the motocross community there is really cool. It's super small, but it's like a family because everyone's from around the world, you know? Everyone here is Dubai and they're like, oh, it's just Arabs, you know, it's just the locals. And you're like, no, actually, like, the population in Dubai is 75% expats. So you go to the motocross track in Dubai and you got South African, English, French, Swedish, Italians, you know, it's amazing. I love it. I loved learning how to ride there, and all my motocross connections, it's cool now because I have friends that ride in South Africa. I got friends that ride in Belgium, you know, it was cool. And then I came here and met my yellow dad, and he made me learn how to ride here and showed me all the tracks here. So it was cool. Yeah, I came here 4 years ago, like I said. I turned 18 in Dubai, packed my bags, and I told my dad I wanted to fly. My dad's a pilot, and he said the only place to let me learn how to fly is Southern California, because it's the most congested airspace in the world. And if you can learn how to fly here, you got LAX, you got San Diego, you got John Wayne, Ontario, you know, you got all these big hubs that if you learn how to fly a little airplane around here, even just your radio work is amazing. So my dad sent me here to learn how to fly. I didn't fly until like 6 months after I was here because I was trying to find a job, and I actually started working at Fox, at the retail store, the headquarters. And yeah, and then I got my pilot's license, private pilot license. And then COVID hit. And it was really slow for like 6, 7 months. I stopped flying, I didn't ride, I didn't work. And then I started flying again. I got all my other licenses, and now I'm a contract pilot trying to get to the airline. So basically that means my phone could ring. It's like, I work for different families, manage airplanes. And it's like private, it's a private industry. So I fly a jet for one management company and then some other airplanes for some private families. So yeah, I got into racing here for the first time last year. I raced the two-stroke world championship. A good buddy of mine is the owner of Lightspeed, and he's really, I call him my American grandpa. He was nice enough to let me use his 250 two-stroke. And I've kept it ever since. And you know, it's hard with me to go flying all the time because I don't have that free time to go riding and staying in shape. Like sometimes I'll leave for 2 weeks, you know, and it's, I don't do anything. I can't ride my mountain bike, can't go riding. So I haven't done much racing because I feel like to go racing, you gotta be in good shape. And lately since, I think it was like since December, I was riding a lot more. So I decided to go ride the two-stroke world championship again at Glen Helen. And I had a blast and I have some free time now. So I was like, I want to do some more local races and maybe even something smaller. And here I am for the Swapmoto race. And it was awesome. It was definitely very different from, you know, those big events. It was a lot less, you know, it's funny saying pressure when I'm like a beginner, but it was a lot more relaxed and it was a lot more enjoyable. I raced it on the vet track and it was very well organized. It moved super quick, which was nice. You know, just, this is definitely something I can recommend to just, you know, break the ice. It was definitely a lot of fun. I want to do it ready next week and I want to go to Glen Helen. Ciao, ciao.